lead race number one, Smoking Joe Hillman, your fast qualifier from early on in the 01 J car. Ryan Ray, the Mableton driver in the 1A car. Dylan Holmes in the 11 car. John Michael Schmier out of Auburn, Alabama, the 294. Jamie Simmons, the blue 77. Larry Bednar, the 3 car, and Dustin Perry piloting the 18 car. 10 laps of distance, Smoking Joe gets out front, noses in front of Ryan Ray. Ryan Ray's going to try to make the top side work, but he's going to slide back, and that'll give the lead to Smoking Joe on lap one. Hillman, Ryan Ray, Michael Schmier, the 11 car of Holmes, and the 77 of Simmons, your front five. Smoking Joe now slides up to the top of the track, and Ryan Ray tries the bottom of the track as everybody's trying to find out where their car is going to work the best. The gumbo clay slicking up here as the night proceeds along. Coming up on the cross flags, halfway home, halfway to go for heat race number one. As Smoking Joe slides up the track, Ryan Ray trying to find some bite down low. Ray will tuck it in there underneath him in the turns one and three, but then he'll slide out and have to fall back a little bit as now Smoking Joe continues to work his car down the track as well, but a bad push. And the 01 J cars, you can see those tires, those front wheels turn hard to the left, but yet that car continues to go up the hill. Just a couple more laps as Ryan Ray lets him know that he's there, gets a touch there on the left rear quarter panel. The bull horns at the bull ringer out. Look out, Ryan Ray trying to duck underneath him. He'll get loose, that'll cost him. It's just a heat race, Ryan. Don't spin it out. It's the white flag will fly for Smoking Joe Hillman in the 01J. Hillman's going to get the first checkered flag of the showdown at Senoia. Ryan Ray will settle for second, followed up by the 294 car of John Michael Schmier and the 11 car of Dylan Holmes. So heat race number one for your showdown at Senoia in the books for the hobby stocks. We have one more 10 lap and then their field will be set for tomorrow.
And they jump to the loud pedal, and the first lap is now underway. Swanger and Poston going wheel to wheel, going into turns three and four, battling for the lead. But it looks like Swanger getting on that patented high side that he knows and loves, and he'll lead lap number one. 9 laps left at Poston down to the bottom, and he's going to grab the traction there side by side, going for the lead into turns three. Poston and Swanger getting it on here to Georgia's baddest bull ring, and Poston to lead that lap around. Oh, Swanger around in turns one. Caution out onto the speedway. Hard lick for Swanger. An here we go. We're wide open again here in our hobby division. Two laps complete. Poston, the young man's going to lead the charge into 3 and 4 with the rest of the field. Single file in tow behind him as they complete lap 3. So Mike Jenkins and Harmon losing more and more moonlight to Poston as he is getting further away from the field. They complete the lap 4 with 6 to go. Flagman Jason Dice getting the halfway marker for our competitors as they will cross the strike. Halfway in, halfway to go. Track going through its metamorphosis stage as it went from a nice grippy track down to a very slick surface, which is really starting to make these drivers move around this speedway to try to find what little grip as they can to hopefully get faster and advance their positions in. 3 to go this time by. Throw up the bullhorns. 2 to go for your race leader as he will cross the strike. The rest of the field will cross in tow behind him. The white rag will fall on this field as Poston will cross the strike. Second, third, and fourth getting ready to take the white flag. Once they call it there, it will be pretty much an official if anyone brings the caution out. Poston brings it in at 3 and 4 and starting outside the pole for tomorrow's feature. Give it to Poston. Second will go to Blake Harmon. Third to Michael Couch. Excuse me, Mike Pop Jenkins in second. Third to Harmon and fourth to Couch.
So the hobby stock feature for the inaugural running of the Showdown at Senoia for that division is now set. So Blair will come out of the pack leading down the back straightaway as McDaniel will tuck in behind him. Mike Nelms giving him a little bump in the rear bumper. Nelms down on the inside. McDaniel now lets him on by as the 29 car of steel goes around in turn number 4, but we're going to stay green. Mike Nelms has made his way past Brandon McDaniel. Now McDaniel comes up and returns the favor in turn number 3. William Blair tries to pull away from the field. Nelms now separates himself by a half car length to a car length over McDaniel. So Matt Steele continuing to struggle with the slicking up surface of the gumbo. Pits open up at noon, grandstands at 2 o'clock, racing at 3:30 as we go back, green flag racing here. Brandon McDaniel off the pace over there down the back straightaway, and it has heated up here in front. Six laps complete. William Blair side by side with Mike Nelms. Nelms on the inside. He'll come out of the turn side by side again. Nelms will edge him at the finish line here. Three laps remain as now, look out, around goes the 17 car of Blair, and he'll connect with Dunny Dillard in the 7 car, and a caution will have to fly. Red flag comes out for Mike Nelms, a former champion in the Bomber Division out of Noonan. As the race right now, looks like it's going to be Dunny Dillard in the 7 car and William Blair in the 17 car. As Nelms will come out of turn 4 clean as a whistle, claim the checkered flag, and Dillard will go in second. Blair will come home third. And Matthew Steele will see them all in the 29 car. So Nelms So the green flag flies on this 10 lap heat race number 2 for your Bomber Division. Garib Wright out front slides up the hill, but everybody else does as well. Junior Hardy takes a look down low, but his car slides up as Wright comes back down off the top of turn number 2. Timmy Harmon now trying to slide that Camaro up a spot, but he'll stay stuck in third. Bright secures his lead and establishes a several car length lead. The battle watch right now looks like it's developing for second and third. Halfway to go. Second place right now held by Junior Hardy, but Tim Harmon continues. Look out, Dura Bright goes around over in turn number 2. Just when you thought the Godfather was on his way to an easy victory, if that restart did anything, it gave the B19 car, Chris Chase, an opportunity to get a little bit closer to those front runners. as he's staying right with Tim Harmon. Junior Harney with a car length lead over him. Europe right now has fought his way back up to the number four spot as the white flag will fly as they come out of turn number four. And the 95 car, Junior Harney, is going to win it. Harmon will come home second, followed by Chase and Dura Bright making his way back up to fourth. So it looks like the front row for tomorrow's $1,000 to win bomber feature for the showdown at Senoia will be the 4N car of Mike Nelms and the 95 car of Junior Harney.
Here we go, Shannon Anther is going to lead the crowd out of turn four. They jump to the loud pedal. Here we go. In the turns one and two, the king of minis, Dan Bennett down to the bottom. Shannon Etheridge going to lead the charge in the turns three and four. Out of four, wheel to wheel for the lead, but Etheridge lead that time around. Tony Kaufman sitting there third on the high side trying to wind that thing up. Dan Bennett down to the bottom, picked up the National 100 last weekend. Guys trying to dip and dab on the speedway. They will clock on for lap number two. They're squaring off for second, coming to the line. Halfway to go. Kaufman and Bennett, that race gets squared away as Bennett is pulling away. Shannon Etheridge still controlling the race as they cross the stripe with four to go in this mini stock heat race. All the building, all the hype for the mini stocks. It's time to put up a shut up. $2,500 is waiting on the line tomorrow night for whoever can win this heat and start from the pole. I'm running out on the field. The bullhorns are out, two to go on this one. Race is pretty much settled in. The closest battle right now between second and third, between Bennett and Kaufman. Fourth and fifth, finally getting settled away with the number 51 of Faulkner, who's ran well here at Senoia over the past few weeks. White flag out on the field. They crossed the stripe. Taking home heat race win number one. Give it to Shannon Etheridge. Second to Bennett Kaufman, making a final swoop to come home third. Oh, hard hit for the lap car, the number seven of Mr. Tats. Tate. So Tate coming across the strike. The spelling getting the little announcer a little bit off key there for a minute. So definitely Shannon Etheridge, unofficially the winner for heat race number one. three stops. And the turns one and two, Rowan and Garrett. That Northeast Nightmare in the 47, piping it up to the top side and getting it in gear. Side by side. Oh, big spin around in turns three and four. That'll bring the caution out. All right, let's try it again. Out of turn four, they get back to the loud pedal. Here we go. Oh, they're going to make it three wide in turns one and two as they pipe it up again to the top side. Here comes Garrett. That Northeast Nightmare makes a little contact with Rowan. Going to make him slide high and Rowan to lead the first circuit of nine to go. Garrett back down to the bottom trying to get under Rowan, but they're going to try to make it three wide coming off turn two. Drivers thinking wisely to back out of it as they're continuing to battle it out for third, coming to the straight. J.J. Garrett looking for some grip as he is making his presence known with Rowan. In the three and four, Rowan high, wide, and handsome. Here comes the Northeast Nightmare to the bottom. Rowan to hold on to the point as they hit the straight. Left cars in the way is going to make Garrett bobble. So Garrett's going to have to get the momentum back up and rolling. Back in the three and four. The very wide corner, and these guys will cross the stripe halfway. Four laps in, six to go. Ah, here we go. Rowan's back mirror is getting full of the 47 again, diving down to the bottom as they will complete the halfway marker this time by. J.J. Garrett continuing to apply the pressure to Rowan for the lead. But the number 28 of Griffin starting to make his way up through the field as he's now challenging for the third spot. But here comes Garrett again to the inside. Four laps to go. Garrett's going to overdrive it. That's going to give Rowan a 4-5 car length lead. Back into three and four, J.J. Garrett again. Trying to feather the throttle and make what he can work to get up there. Three to go this time by for the field. Rowan driving off into the Senoia Raceway moonlight with the two to go marker coming out this time by. Oh, we got one off the pace here on the front stretch. He gets it back going and we continue to race. They're gonna take the white flag this time by for Rowan. That 28 machine of Griffin has now closed up on Garrett. As both of them taking a swoop down in the catfish pond at the bottom of the speedway. Who's gonna dig down there in the ooey gooey sticky mud? Rowan a hold on. He will take this heat race win with Garrett in second. Griffin will come home third. And the number 25 of Singleton will round out the top four. Down to the bottom to Villarica Villain. We got one around in turns number two and another one off the pace here in turns number four. They will cross the stripe. So Denver Step. Todd Brewster picked up the July KMSA race here last season. We're going to see if he can make something work here at his home track and they're off. So the three of Brandon Knight shuts the door on Brewster, but Brewster's gonna get it going. He's going to match the loud pedal, and they're going to go wheel-to-wheel, hub-to-hub in three and four. The Villarica villain trying to get up on a Knight as they come to the line, and Knight will barely clip him at the line, and there's still eight circuits to go. So Knight finds some grip up top, and he's going to get in front of Todd Brewster as they go into turns three and four. But Mike Younger looking to pick up that big money win. If he can make something work and hang on for the next seven circuits around the Speedway, we got one around here at the bottom of turns four. Month or so. And then Knight's gonna take a peek up under Bam Bam as they come out of turn number two. Brandon Knight, couple of wins on the KMSA, last one comes. Oh, and around he goes in the middle of one and three and four. Just when he's about to get that hype from the announcer, and the announcer jinx kick in, and there you go. For heat race number three, they come out of four and drop the hammer. Here we go. So Todd Brewster is now going to see what he can make work against Younger. Faulkner going around in the number 44, and the white flag is out. Faulkner loops it back around and gets it in gear. Todd Brewster trying to find some grip. He's got a little run going against Younger. He's going to make one last stab out of turn four. Younger's going to stride high, and he will hold on to win this one. Second to Brewster. Third to the 57 machine of McGuire. And the 0-1 of Denver step will round out the top four.
Look at that. You're winning.
Flagman Jason Dykes gives him the one to go. This lap's for the show. The next lap, we'll see him go. Chad Harrington, your race director up top. Transponder scoring system. 25 laps of green flag racing on deck here as we kick off all of our feature racing here for the showdown at Senoia. You folks ready for a little racing? Hellman's going to take over the point through turns one and two, as we've already got a spinner in turn one. And the caution will have to come out. We'll reline them back up and try to restart them again. Everybody will be able to hold their position. When Mr. Dykes thinks it's a fair start for everybody, he throws the green flag to start the race, not the drivers in the front row. Smoking Joe slides up in front of Polston, and that'll shut him down. And everybody stays clean so far through three. Ryan Rain out of the inside of Polston. Wilson trying to hold down that low line. Mike Jenkins settles into the number four spot, followed up by Blake Harmon. Here comes James Swanger. Swanger trying to make the climb from near the back of the field, already up to sixth place. Also up there on the side, on the high side, is the 11 car of Dylan Holmes. But Hillman kind of climbs up the hill. That gives an opportunity for that young gun out of Lithia Springs to close the gap on that leader. Swanger's making that top side work as he joins the top five here. Still got 20 laps to continue to climb. Also on the charge, that 11 car of Chillin Dylan Holmes. The young man out of Alabama now up to sixth place as he follows Swanger. Look at that, though. A good race down the back straightaway as Blake Harmon and Holmes flip-flop sixth and seventh place. Burleson continues to get good runs on the 01 car of Hillman, but cannot get it done. Blake Harmon's going to go around over here in turn number four. A good job by Simmons to avoid, and the caution will have to fly. And just in time, as Hillman and Polston were starting to approach the lap traffic. So, interesting way to restart a race, but the leader. And the big pileup has happened over here in turn number one. As it looks like the 11 car of Holmes, who was doing a great charge towards the front, gets caught. I think everybody's ready for it this time. So Ryan Ray trying to get that 1A car to Mableton to stick up top. He'll pump in, look out, he gets right behind Hillman, and around goes Hillman. Pops Jenkins, flies up into the peppermint stick, so does Dylan Holmes, and look out, Larry Bednar with no brakes whatsoever. He piles right into Holmes and Simmons. Austin's car working just as good as it did last night during qualifying and heat races as he builds a pretty good lead over a very strong contender in the 36 car of Swanger. Smoke and Joe already climbing back up through the field as he's already up into fifth place. Goes to work on Ryan Knight. Knight in the 17 car. Justin Perry off the pace in the 18 car coming out of turn number four. And looks like we're going to have a caution as he's obviously got some problems here with the front suspension on the 18 car. So Bolston will lead him to the cross flags as Smoke and Joe and Swanger battle it out for second and third. Simmons goes around and the caution will have to fly again. Swanger continuing to try that high side. He if the Reinsberg Hot Shoe can get that thing to stick over in turns 3 and 4, he might have something for Polston. As he makes his way past Smoking Joe. Smoking Joe now fades it back into third. Hudson's barbecue smells awfully, awfully good here behind us. Swanger now trying a little bit harder on the top side of turn number two. See if he can get a run off of two to chase down Polston. He continues to inch closer and closer, the young man out of Lithia Springs. But he's also running out of laps to work on, the youngster. He'll try again, high off of turn number two, but he can't get a good enough run down the back straightaway. Might have to change up his strategy a little bit as he fades back there out of turn number four. Polston hugging that inside line. If you're going to beat him, you're going to have to beat him on the outside as they'll come to the flag stand. Five laps remain. Continuing to try to get a run on the young man, Polston, the double zero car, but Polston doing a good job holding off all those threats. Swanger with a good run off the top side, but he can't get underneath him. Two laps to go, the bullhorns are out at the bull ring. Polston makes a little bit of a mistake down here in turn number one. That's going to get Swanger side by side with him. Charge down into turn number three. Now Swanger's going to slide high. Polston hammering it down low. The white flag is out and Polston's going to go down a spot, but can he fight back and win it? Swanger worked that top side to perfection. And if he can get it to stick for 300 more feet, he will win it. Swanger will win the showdown at Senoia for the Hobby Sock Division. Polston will hang on for the second place position. Third place will go to Smoking Joe Hillman. Ryan Ray, fourth place.
And let's hear it up for your race winner, James Swanger. All right now, big boy, you have had a fantastic season and you got multiple wins and you cap it off with the biggest win in this class for the year. How does it feel, brother?
It's unbelievable. I don't know. I don't even know what to say right now. I don't know.
Man, right now I know you got a big crew back there that are glad to see you win this thing, man. Who all back there you want to thank for getting this one?
Everybody, my family, the Dukes. If it weren't for them, I wouldn't even have a ride. So, I mean, I can't. It's just everybody that helps me out. I love it.
Now, with that going on in that race, Dalton Polston, he got out front. You jumped to the high side, man. You was hanging on for dear life up there. What was it up there really making you stay committed to that top side, brother?
I just love the top side. That's where my car works.
Definitely, man. Congratulations. We'll see you hopefully again in 2017, Victor Lane. Let's hear it up for your race winner, James Swanger.
I don't care what you say.
All right, now, Dalton, you came in. ran second. You led majority of the race after the caution fell on Joe Hillman, man. In that race, though, you fought tooth and nail with one of the best out here. How did it feel to get up there, at least close to winning that victory?
It felt pretty good. First time running up here on the gumbo. And just, I know he's been racing all of his life, and it's been pretty good 3 days here.
Now, take us back to that last lap. Swanger on the outside, you digging hard at the bottom, got those tires squealing, man. What was it going to take if you had to redo it to hopefully come out in front of Swanger?
Probably be a little bit more smoother with the throttle.
But definitely. Who you want to thank for this big, for a great second place tonight?
I want to thank God first, and my mom and dad, and Lewis Rogers, Willie's Record Service, Georgia Arms, Matt Bishop, Bishop Racing Engines, Reliable Sanitation. So, thank y'all.
Definitely. Let's hear it up again for your second place man tonight, Dalton Poston.
Just good race, man.
All right.
Long time, man. Glad I can finally get to you on the way.
I'm good. All right, man. Let's let the crowd get a good look at you up here so we can see you real quick. So, Smoking Joe, Victor Lane has not been a stranger to you. You started right up there on the front row, and unfortunately, the caution fell down on you, man. Was that the tipping point that may have caught you this race tonight?
Absolutely.
Now, out there, you led early. You had one of the clearest, strongest cars. Did you really think you're going to have these boys covered for that whole 25-lapper?
Pretty much. I mean, when I had to go to the rear, I just burned the car up coming back through the field and pretty much used the tires up.
So out of burning those tires, the boys in front of you there, did you think you might have had just a little more car if maybe a caution had came out for you?
I think if a caution would have came out, I probably would have cooled the tires a little bit and would have had a good run at it. But, you know, that's a 50-50 shot you take.
Now, definitely, who you want to thank for this great third place tonight?
I'd like to thank the sponsors, Neighborhood Auto Center, CNS Auto Electric, Need a Hand Trucking, my crew chief, Shane Tidwell, Hurricane Race Engines. He built us one heck of a power plant. And my wife, she wasn't here. She went to the Alabama football game today.
Roll Tide, roll, right?
That's right, Roll Tide.
Definitely. Let's hear it up again for Smoking Joe Hillman.
Famous in Florida.
We're getting close to locking and loading for our bomber feature. Mike Nam done found something on the top side. Two-man's got to put on his belt. He's got to ratchet in that boat. He's got to come up to third. Good run for William Blass. He's now starting to run down Mike Nelms. And down the backstretch they go. William Blair going for a hard move into turn three and four, three wide for a second. Back into one and two. William Blair gets loose. Here comes Harmon to the inside. Meanwhile, out front, Junior Hardy in the number 95 getting away from him. But those guys still getting at it, coming to the line. Great race here at the Georgia's Baddest Bull Race, Senoia Raceway. William Blair, now loaded up the pistol, he's taking aim. He done fired it, he's up under Nelms. Drag race to the line for a second. God almighty, these guys are racing. Blair's gonna change up the line and take it to the bottom. Him and Nelms are again side by side. Incredible race, Harmon in the mix. Harmon's knocking on the back door. Those guys are starting to go blow for blow. Holy cow, it's going to a four-man race for a second. William Blair, Mike Nelms, and Harmon. Wow, wow, wow. These guys turn it up right now here, Senoia. William Blair back to the bottom in a 17. Getting under Mike Nelms in the number four side. We got one around in turns three and four. Caution out. And ouch. All right, the C double foul coming out of four. They get to the loud pedal. Here we go. Off in the turns, one and two, William Blair's going to the top side. It's two time. Oh, we got one around on the back stretch. The L1 machine of Harmon. So Tim Harmon, oh, Thunder out of turn four. They dropped the hammer. Here we go. Just like the Jug Man, they're back at it in the turns. One and two, these guys are really slipping and sliding. William Blair, and we got one around in the middle of two, excuse me, turn three, and that will bring the caution out. All right, here we go again out of four, they get at it. All right, Mike, now the slip back on that start, and William Blair's gonna get it going up to the top side. Chris Arnett getting into the mix, but William Blair on the top side, making a beeline run, coming for the lead. The Whitesburg, Georgia driver has got that Neesmith street stop, giving it all he can. As he comes after the 95, he's knocking on the back door for the lead as they come to the straight. As the sun is setting, the track's starting to get a little more grip. These guys are feathering that throttle, trying to find some grip somewhere on the track. Halfway in, halfway to go this time by. Junior Hardy. So far, he's got something working good in the Lightning McQueen number 95 machine. William Blair has closed up the gap that much more. They are continuing. And we got a spinner in the middle turn four. The number 28 machine going into the spin cycle. Tad Willingham, he gets back up and rolling. No caution. William Blair back to the top side at four. And we got another one getting close. Wow, these guys. Don't say these guys ain't in some wheelmen. They have done a fantastic job saving these cars from destruction. But God almighty, William Blair, a applying the pressure to the number 95, and they continue to bail it out. Laps are winding out in this one. And oh, William Blair has broken in turns one and two. And wow.
And out of turn number four, they will get back in and then come screaming down the street. Chris Arnett done moved up to second, but Dillard getting his car in motion and caution out onto the speedway in turns two. And out of four, they're back to the throttle, and here we go. What a restart for Arnett as he is wheel-to-wheel with your leader in the turns one and two. Chris Arnett was digging hard, but Junior Hardy's gonna find the traction and get away from him. But Mike Nams jumping up on the high side, trying to make some dig as they come to the line. A whole hornet's nest right there from second on back. God almighty, what a move by Nams. He's gonna go flying by. Don't count out Harmon three wide. Wow, what a race here in the Bombers. They're going to go four wide. No love lost. Brandon McDaniel's going to get hit, and he falls back. Caution out. We got one around in turns four. Here at the Showdown, Senoia, but we're going to get back at it out of turn four. They piping it up. Let's ride. Single file starts from this point on. Mike Nams drives it up way up the bank, and then he's gonna get a diamond off run coming out of the back. Chris Arnett and Harmon squaring off a position, but what a run they got on the 95 of Julia Hardy. Not much time left in this one as these guys are fighting tooth and nail. William Blair already up into the top five. He takes it down to the bottom, trying to go for that 2-for-1 Waffle special. We got one around here in the middle, 3 and 4. Caution out. Not yet. Willingham gets it back in motion. We remain racing. Harmon and Arnett still getting at each other hard for the third position. William Blair now up to fifth. Mike Nams has found something on the top side, and he is staying hanging on to that third position. Willingham's going to get the move over flag as Junior Hardy has now put him a lap down. Mike Nams drives it down and shuts the door. Here comes Blair. Blair's now up to fourth, trying to make a hard charge. Mike Nams now feeling the heat off Harmon as they battle it out for second. Two laps to go. Time to put up or shut up. Nams and Harmon again battle it out. Blair trying to hold on a fourth, and look at Harmon to the top side. Not much time left as the white flag has fallen. Only one lap to go. Dripping too much sauce for your leader, and he's going to take the checker flag of Junior Hardy. Second to Mike Nams. And third to Tim Harmon. You came out there, you put on a good race. Junior Hardy, I'm so sorry, Junior. Congratulations on your first major big win here at Senoia Raceway. With this big win, how does it feel to finally knock off a top-notch win?
Oh, it feels real good. It's been out of about 13 years, and it feels good to come back like this.
Definitely. Who you want to thank for a marvelous win this evening?
I'd like to thank Tim Harmon and Blake Harmon. Tim's my brother-in-law. They gave me the opportunity to drive this car.
So after 13 years, it feels mighty good, and you show these young boys how to do it, right?
Yeah, as old guys, it's kind of hard. So.
Definitely. Let's hear it again for your race winner, Junior Hardy. Oh, there we go. How does it feel to just come up just a little bit shy tonight and trying to get that nice big win? How does it feel, brother?
Well, that's about the worst feeling in the world, but just a little bit short tonight.
Well, I know you put on a fantastic race. You made a big, hard run for the front. What were you missing to get the win tonight?
Well, we're running on this black ice tonight, so just that forward bite. Just need a little bit more forward bite.
Who do you want to thank for a great second place?
My dad. He does everything. So.
Good job, man. Let's hear it up for Mike Nims. All right, there, Tim. Good run tonight, man. You came up third. Not exactly what you would like to try to get the win, but how was the car for you this evening?
I was probably a third-place car. That's about all I had.
Well, you definitely kept going and running as hard as you can. Did you think you were going to have enough maybe to get around the four when y'all battled out earlier?
Yeah, I thought I could get by the four, but I didn't want to touch him. I didn't want to bump him to do it, and he has the same respect for me, so I raced him clean like he would do me, you know?
Now, that's great sportsmanship. Who you want to thank for a great third-place run tonight?
I just thank all the people that come to the racetrack and help me. And Junior Hardy's my brother, Starla Barnes. And
we're glad to hear. Let's hear for Tim Harmon.
Go, the limited late bottles. Page and Knowles. Courtney and Dooley. Newborn and Britton, the front six cars to start this one. Michael Page with a couple feature victories this season in the limited late bottles. Second, Dooley trying to make that top side work as everybody stays in order. Nobody spinning around as they charge through three and four. Look out. Gentry gets bumped out. The 99 of Hunter. Roy will go around and the caution will have to fly. So Page leads the field back to greens. We got three wide races going on in several different areas. TJ Britton, the 85 car of Alabama, shoots on past up into fourth place. Some good battles back here at the tail end of the field as everybody works on Thomas Mewborn. Mewborn kind of got hooked there by the 171 car, Courtney. He holds his position, though. Everybody bunches up accordion style behind. Oliver Gentry off the gas, and everybody gets around him. Problems with the 03 cars. Looks like he might turn into the infield, and he will. Gentry out early. Page and Dooley, the dueling 18 cars at the front of the field. Knowles in third. Britton in fourth, and it's several car lengths back to Mewborn, Mills, Corney, and Wood. Thank you. race to watch right now. Coming out of turn number four as Jody Oles and the 85 car Britton battle it out at the flag stand and into turn one. The 66 car Knowles, but Knowles continues to fight back on the top side, side by side out of turn four. Britton has him by a quarter of a foot. Or 3 inches. Michael Page has made his way into lap traffic. And the caution will have to come out. It's Gary Harden. It spun down to the bottom of turn number two, right in front of Michael Page, as Page is just starting to get into the lap traffic. The gas to get the green flag to fly. Kyle Corney trying to get a run on the 18 car Mewbourne. He'll get it done as Mewbourne slides up and is stuck on the high side. Here comes Mills. Mills will hammer him in the driver's side door. As it's a mad scramble from sixth place on back. Meanwhile, up front, Magic Matt has caught up to Michael Page and put a little pressure on the veteran out of Winston that had such a good run up at Eldora Speedway just a few weeks ago. Magic Matt on the high side. Now he's going to sling down and try to get a run on the inside. Now he'll switch back to the top side. Two, three, and four side by side with Michael Page. And the caution will have to come out as Brent Harlan goes around and around there in the back straightaway on his way into three and comes to rest on the inside of turn number three, just below the scoreboard. So Magic Matt put a little pressure on Page there for the lead position. Not too far behind. That was a good run again between Britton and Knowles. So some good racing here in your limited late model division, a real racy track here. So we'll unfurl the green flag. Down low, look at that, the 171 car of Corney gets by TJ Britton, but it will not matter as the 25 car of Matt Larson goes around down over here in turns one and two. So let's see if we can get a few more laps under green here. Page continues to lead the way, but Dooley trying to make that top side work. Page now slides up, going to run about mid groove. The car on the move right now is that 171 car of Kyle Corney. Corney running third. Now Knowles is going to work by on the high side as the guys are starting to move up the track a little bit, maybe find a little bit up top here before we go to the super late models. Little slide job on the 66 of Jody Knowles. Now here comes TJ Britton. What a race for third, fourth, and fifth. You can throw a blanket over the top over those three cars as now Britton slides down on the inside to get side by side with Corney. Knowles looking for room to run in fifth place. Page continues to lead this race as he has a several car length lead over Dooley. TJ Britton now slides up into third and Corney resumes that battle with the 66 car Knowles. Also a car on the moves, the 88 car of Russ Ogletree. Ogletree has found something up top as well as he joins the top six. Page, Dooley, Britton, Knowles, Carney, and Ogletree. Down to single-digit laps remaining. Russ Ogletree using that topside. Gets a good run on the 171 of Carney. It's down into turn number three. Now he's going to slide back up into the middle groove. Meanwhile, coming out of turn number two, does it look like Dooley might be gaining on Page? Maybe a little, but he's only got seven laps if he's going to take this one away and steal it from Page. Page and Dooley now starting to get their way into lap traffic as six remain. Page will be the first one to get past the lap car, Dakota Weeks, and Weeks is going to go around. And everybody will avoid him as the caution will have to fly as Dakota Weeks, the D8 car out of Douglas. Six more laps to go for your Limiteds. Starts to flex his muscle down on the inside. KJ Britton finding a little bit of grip down there alongside the interior concrete, and now Britton has moved himself up into the number two spot. Matt Dooley holding on there. Thomas Mewborn has moved up. The bull horns at the bull ring have come out for Michael Page. Now Magic Matt Dooley, look out, he gets into Britton. Britton's going to go around, and the caution will have to come out. As Britton and Dooley were battling it out back and forth there for second and third place. White flag flies. Time to put up or shut up for the drivers here in the Limited Late Models. The young driver out of Newton has found his way up to the front four cars, but Page is going to win it. Dooley will settle for second. Knowles will get third. Trey Wood will get fourth. How about that for the young man out of Newton? And for a first time.
All right, Michael, you came in, man. You got the best opportunity. You started up on the front row. You led every lap. You dominate this race, man. Did you know you had them covered like that?
No. This one of my, I ain't raced this car all years. It's an old car. It's been mine. It's just so easy to drive. It's just a good one. Had fun.
Man, this West Georgia fence car has done you wonders over the entire year. Have Stacy and the rest of these boys really gave you the right piece to keep on the winning streak going to the final?
Yeah, they helped me a lot all year. You know, my mom and dad, TNT Trucking, they helped me a lot. All of our help. CNS Auto Electric, that man sticks with me when nobody ever will, and I really appreciate everything he's done for all of us.
Oh, yeah, buddy. Who you want to thank for the win tonight?
TNT Trucking, West Georgia Fence, CNS Auto Electric, all my help, Sky, mom and dad, just everybody. I really had a good time. We just got to do two more. We'll be all right.
Hopefully you can make three in a row tonight. Let's hear it again for Michael Page. Yeah. All right, then, Matt, you had a fantastic run. You came up just a little bit short, and you came up second, buddy. How was the car for you tonight?
Yeah, good car. I just really feel bad about what happened to me in the 85. That's all my fault. You know, I was there, but I had gotten the brakes, and I tried to stop, but we just going for the same piece of room, and I feel really bad. But, you know, we had a good car, just came a little short.
Definitely. You put on a great show, buddy. Who you want to thank? Well, who you want to thank for the win, for your great second place, buddy?
Scott's Auto Machine, LD Enterprises, Chick-fil-A Dwarf House, and just all the fans.
Thank you so much. Let's hear from Magic Matt Dooley. All right. Long awaited for you there, Jody. You had a fantastic run. You ran from a little bit further back, and you tried to get up there with them boys, but what was it going to take to hopefully get you to victory lane tonight?
Well, you know, I thought Clint, he was going to give us a guess there. I don't know what happened to him. That's a bad deal. That would have been a really good show for the fans. But, you know, you got to give it to Doug and the Mass. He's putting this on, you know, biggest race here. You're not going to see racing like this anywhere else around here. You know, it's a really good night. I'm probably down on motor a little bit, and it's starting to latch down a little bit. But all in all, it's a good race, good side-by-side, a little rubbing everything. I think Knowles Trucking, Clayton Signs, Lamar Hunt Automotive, probably a pretty good hobby motor in here. Kept up with them guys pretty good.
Hey, great job tonight. Let's hear it again for Jody Knowles. Fans, lights are out. The mini stocks are about to erupt here at the Georgia Baddest Bull Race at our raceway. All the trash talk, all the hype. Who's going to be king of the minis out of four? They jump to the loud pedal. Here we go. Jamie Rowan and Shannon Anthony, we got a power around each other going into one and two. And we got one around in the middle. Tossing out onto the Speedway. Ty Brewster, that top six is absolutely phenomenal. Out of four, here we go again. Third time's a charm for Shannon Etheridge and Jamie Rowan. They're going to get back to the loud pedal. Here we go. And they're off in the turns one and two. These guys are going to span out like the hornet's nest. The tag belt has been set. These Bumblebee four cylinders spanning two, three, four wide off the corners. And Shannon Etheridge lead lap number one. Huge pile up here right on the front stretch to 74 of Harold Leaf, the 51 machine of Faulkner, the number 44 is well evolved. Alright, here we go, out of turn four, the field gets to the loud pedal, they're off. What a restart for Tom Brewster. For the CBS end. And they're still wrecking. And Faulkner cutting a couple of donuts. Tough break for the number 52 of Horton. Him and the little CBS end. That will end his night all the way. Sliding hard out of four. They're going to go wheel to wheel to the line.
up the third water. Caution is waving. shift back out onto the speedway. Final restart, green flags out, here we go. Off into turns one and two they go, they're gonna slug it out badly. And caution out on the speedway. I mean, wow, your race leader, Dan Bennett. Shannon Etheridge also caught in the mix. Showdown here in Senoia with the minis. Second going to the 03. Race winner, Tony Kaufman. Awesome, awesome run by Mr. Tony this evening. All right, Tony, come on up here and lay that cross for her.
Man, it's long enough, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you have came to this speedway on numerous occasions and have not quite been able to knock off that big win. And tonight you did it, man. How does it feel?
Oh, it feels great. Feels real great.
Now, throughout that race, you had a little contact. The right side of this car. How was that pretty much a slobber knocker steel cage match?
It was intense. I thought I was out, but they told me it was good, so I just kept going.
Now, who you want to thank for the win tonight?
Well, I'd like to thank John and Bo Miner and Judd. They're my crew chief. They got it together for me tonight. I've had the worst luck this year. I mean, the worst. So this feels good.
Definitely, man. We've watched you go through a lot of trials, and this is a perfect season under with $2,500 in your pocket.
Yeah.
So definitely, let's hear it again for your race winner, Tony Kaufman. Come down here to the second place man tonight. The hard charger of the race.
Come on, Brandon.
Not much, man.
All right, there, Brandon, you came into this event. You started the furthest in the back, and you made a hard beeline charge to the front, man. Did you think you might have had the car that could have won this thing?
I think if I'd pushed it a little harder, probably could, but I was content where I was at.
You're a little out of breath, man. Was that intense of a race?
It was a long one, that's for sure. Very long.
Now, who you want to thank for this win tonight?
I'd like to thank my wife for bringing me the parts like I asked her to. I'd like to thank my dad. I'd like to thank all my family for coming and supporting me. I'd like to thank Tony over there for Rachel McLean. Bam Bam there for Rachel McLean. I'd just like to thank everybody. Thank you.
Definitely. Let's hear it up for your second place, man, and Knight. All right. Here we go. Oh, Bam Bam. Well, boss. I know you really, really had this race marked on the schedule to get the victory lane, but unfortunately just came up a little bit short. What was it going to take to try to get this car up there and battle it out with those boys up front?
It handles pretty good. It's just, you know, we need more green flag laps. We need to actually learn how to race. That was wild.
Definitely, and throughout that wild race, man, you've seen cars dip, dab, dodge, and play pinball a little bit. Did you, and to come looking like that, that ain't too bad.
Yeah, fortunately, I was up front. We qualified good, so we didn't have to put up with a lot of it, but, man, it was wild even up there.
Well, I want to thank you for a great third place tonight.
I don't know. It's pretty emotional tonight. I lost my best friend, or one of my best friends last night, and I just don't want to talk no more.
Understood, brother. Let's hear it up for Bam Bam Mike Younginger.
Do you remember Gary? Yeah, he died last night.
The loud pedal, as our buddy Dwayne would say. Super late model drivers should go to staging. Super late model drivers to staging, please. Ballard and Hickman. Knowles and Lunsford, here we go. Riley Hickman trying to find the bite up top. He's going to scoot in front using that high side momentum. Ballard's going to stay down on that low side. Hickman turns the corner. They'll be side by side at the line. Hickman by just an edge over Ballard on lap one. Cat Daddy Clint Smith is already up to fifth place as he battles with a 39 car, Bobby Lunsford. Smith trying to make that top side work as well. He'll make it past Lunsford and go to fourth. Stick. Marty Lunsford running in the fifth place position. Mike Brunner Jr. now with Cochran right behind him. The flying eye of Craig Scott also charging in down on the low side. A few guys liking that top side. Hickman kind of going about the middle groove right now. Pollard follows him through there. Clint Smith trying to make that car sing a little bit on the top side. Trying to get a run on throwing Dylan Knowles in the 66 as Hickman now has gotten into the lap traffic, putting Newell down a lap first. Smith now dives down low as he tries to go from top to bottom. But Knowles slammed the door shut on the Cat Daddy. Everybody about to get into lap traffic. Hickman now caught up behind Baker and that guy. Hickman makes his way past Petey Cochran. Ballard is able to use that lap traffic to kind of gain a little bit of ground on it. It was now Big Jim Mankin and Dow Kirkland in the sights of your leaders. Meanwhile, here coming out of turn number four, Cat Daddy still working on lap traffic, trying to stay close to the 66 rules. Marty Lunsford still holding down the top five position. Miller and Tom Maddox now running sixth and seventh. The exterior concrete as they're all trying to get around the spun car of Petey Cochran. Cochran getting caught. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, the big one in the grid late model division. Right underneath the scoreboard in a precarious position, so the caution comes out. Riley Hickman will lead him back to green flag racing. Here we go again.
Get up.
Cat Daddy Clint Smith trying to use that inside line. He won't get first, but he'll get second. As Hickman, Smith, Pollard, here comes Maddox down to the inside. Hickman continuing to flex his muscle. On Pollard's car as Pollard comes up lame over in turn number three, and he's going to park it up at the top of the turn. So the caution will have to fly. And Riley Hickman all of a sudden has to get up on the wheel as Cat Daddy has caught up to him and putting the pressure on. Everybody. everybody bunched together. They know that the laps are ticking away, and if they're going to make a run, this restart might be the one. A little bit of bumping, a little bit of banging. Everybody stays going the right direction through three and four. Two and a half laps to go. If Smith's going to make a run, it's going to have to come right now. The bullhorns are out at the bullring. Maddox trying to make the car stick down low. Checkered flag's going to come out of turn number four. Oh, look out. We've got two cars hard into the interior wall. As Riley Hickman will pick up the victory. But Corey Payton hard into that concrete wall in the back straightaway. He was battling it back there with the 83 car of Kyle Cochran and a couple of other drivers, and both hard into the concrete. Cochran made it through unscathed, but can't tell who the other car is that's down there on the inside of turn number three.
Well, since you come down, I need that mic.
Take it. You want me to put this up here?
Oh, well, however you want.
I'm going to use it down there. I'll be there.
So Riley Hickman picking up the victory here tonight in the $2,500 payday. Cap Daddy getting close, but we'll have to finish in the runner-up spot here tonight. And Jake Knowles with a great run. Hustler Riley Hickman!
Yeah, I thought it was up there.
Come around up here, Riley. Get a word. We're one of the best in the Southeast. Crew Chief Urkel here with us.
Thank you, man.
All right, Riley. You started on that front row for the night. You get your second crate win out here in dominant fashion. But that 44 dove up under you a few times, man. Did you think you were going to hold him off in the closing laps?
I don't know. You know, he's kind of God down here, if you want to ask people. You know, he gets around here better than anybody else does. And we kid back and forth. He wears them out down here all the time. So, you know, you read about him and hear about him all the time. So, heck, we'll take it, you know. And this car is a pretty new car. We still got some bugs to work out of it, so we just need to keep working on this thing a little bit.
Definitely. Now, going forward, man, for 2017, what are we going to see out of Riley Hickman for the race season?
Who knows? This is November.
I understood, brother. Four-time champion, over 20-plus wins. This will be win, what, 23 for the year? Oh, he don't even lost count. That's how you do it, brother. But who you want to thank for the win tonight?
I definitely got to thank Urkel for putting up with me. You know, I give him a hard time, and, you know, he makes it worthwhile. So Chip at CVR Race Cars, he builds a good race car, and Hoosier Tire South. And this has got an engine from Eagle in it. Them guys, they do a good job there with a crate motor program. So if we can keep going, we'll be all right.
Definitely. Well, Urkel, he don't have much good to say about you either, but I don't care what he say, you are with me, Riley. Definitely. Let's hear that for the hustler, Riley Hickman. All right, we're going to come down here to the Cat Daddy, Clint Smith. Now, Cat, that was a well of a run right there as you challenged Riley Hickman, especially in the closing laps. Did you think you had enough race car to get around the R1, buddy?
Yeah, if that caution don't come out with five to go, I think we was pretty good. I was going to race him clean, though, and I did. So it don't get returned a lot, but I just want to know I raced him clean, and he had a good race car. Congratulations to him.
Definitely. Who do you want to thank for this great, awesome run tonight?
I got STO, Sharpsburg Takeout here local with me. Clyburn Tank Line has been on my car forever. I got Tim Wilson, and I got good job. I got Tim Wilson and Marcus Casel, been with me all year, and I can appreciate everybody that gives all the cars and the hard work. Andy and Stacy give me at the shop, and David, my wife and daughter, all the stuff we do, but all the fans that come out every week, and I'm glad y'all come support the shows and keep us doing what we like to do.
Definitely. Great job tonight, Cat. We'll hopefully see you do it again here in a couple of weeks at West Georgia, brother. Thank you. Final man down here.
Oh, there we go.
And the lovely Cindy Knowles, cruise with the Champion Cruises. All right, that brother, not exactly how you wanted to end it in third. I know you want that first place, man, but you had to come fighting through that field. Did you think you had enough car if the laps had ran out towards the end?
I mean, I don't know, Riley. He's always good in this kind of condition, and we was pretty good. Just had to start way back through there, and we was just, you know, we was pretty good there. But I got in when Bubba's motor went down. I got into him, messed my right front up, so I really couldn't steer the last five or six laps. But we've had mixed feelings about this place all year. We've only been down here once. This makes our second time, but it's a pretty cool racetrack.
Definitely. I know it took you a while to adapt to the new slick Senoia. So how much more are you liking this as it's starting to pick up on your slick program?
Yeah, it's a fun. I mean, you know, you can race like with top, bottom, wherever. So you can race wherever you want to, just wherever your car works best at. So it's a pretty fun track.
Definitely great run tonight, man. Let's head out for the Rome Rocket, Jake Knowles.